Shy Cranberry Juice, and they said, hey, would you like to help us develop this? I said, sure. And I read it, and I felt like I was back at home with all the women that I grew up with, strong Southern women with a lot of spunk. And that mirrors these two writers. And I'm going to give it all over to them, and they are going to explain more about the development and where we are right now with the workshop. And take it away, ladies.
Well, thank you guys all for coming tonight. We're thrilled to have you all. We started this project about 9 months ago, and when Facebook Productions approached us, and that's the amazing Greg Gladys, who's here with us tonight. Thank you for coming. And from Rhode Island,
not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and petition present your requests to God.
Pastor, your one o'clock should be here in 5 minutes.
The pastor pops an Alka-Seltzer and uses his inhaler.
Is this my real life? Is this some fantasy? Caught in a battle and the lions are chasing me. Bowing my head and praying that you rescue me. I'm just a poor boy. I need some grace because I'm in a mess. I can't fix doing this. Is the pits any way that this goes will not make it better for me? We'll see. Jesus, what do I do? Go into the lion's den to face this struggle once again. Jesus, life was just so good, but now I've got to step into the flames. Jesus, didn't mean to let you down. If I can't do it this time, then please don't hate me. I'm a man, just a man, and I don't think I can.
Pastor, they're here.
It's too late. They're here right now. Nothing left to do but to shout and pray to you. Goodbye, everybody. I've got to go. Gotta leave this world behind and face the truth. I don't want to fail. I sometimes wish I didn't do ministry. Don't you think you can trick me and tell me a lie? Don't you think we can fix this? We're going to try. Oh, ladies, we gotta do. Arrived here 5 years ago as head pastor of this church. There was a thriving community of saints.
Amen.
Like a beacon of light, shining God's love across this dark land.
Preach it, Pastor.
And you four were pillars. All strong pillars. The foundation of the ministries that made this fine church an example for all.
That's right.
But in the last 2 years, you have single-handedly ruined every ministry, every outreach, every opportunity we've had in this church, all while racking up $60,000 in debt for the women's ministry alone, 4 arrest records for disorderly conduct, and 1 for thievery.
What?
You have left me no choice ban you all from participating in any church activities besides Sunday morning worship. Now, who would like to start?
Need. she got it back. And besides, it was we got water aerobics and the talent show, bingo. Oh, and timeshare presentations every Saturday. That's where you get the free breakfast. But mind you, you have to stay awake for the whole thing. Money check. Of course, there's church. Have you thought about where you might be fellowshipping?
I'm not much of a churchgoer.
The Lord makes room for old times, and so do we.
You will be fellowshipping with us.
Or fellow shopping.
I was actually joining the bingo club, and they meet on Sunday mornings. I like to gamble.
Well, that's very interesting information. You thinking what I'm thinking, girls?
I think she has potential for the QSS.
What is that?
The Quarter Slot Sisters, honey.
It's a very selective society of upwardly mobile ladies who like to partake occasionally in the fine art of numerification of coinage.
You mean gambling?
No, gambling is a sin. We only play the quarter slots, and we always give 10% back to the church.
Not
a well, I can. How do I apply?
You don't apply, honey. You get selected by God and the selection committee.
Who is the selection committee?
You're looking at them.
Oh, how many members are there?
Three. The other two died. But we don't like to talk about that.
Well, she's trying to say that there may be an opening in our membership very soon. But first, we do need to deal with your canine situation. We have always had a strict policy. No pets, no children, and no one under 55.
You need your AARP card to get into this place, honey. We're here to play.
I didn't know about the age requirement. I turned 53 in March. I mean, the housing was affordable. It just seemed like a safe community.
You don't look a day over 52. How do you do it? Oil of layer, Dove.
You Dove, that one with the commercial with all them fat ladies in their underwear? That was really disturbing.
Actually, I moved here to work in the anti-aging industry with one of the most renowned plastic surgeons in the Atlanta area.
Dr. Nozawa? His waiting list is 9 months.
You can have a baby before you get some Botox or happy. she's resisting.
Scene 3, interior church office, present day.
That's lovely how y'all met, but aren't we getting off topic here? What about the $9,000 location scouting trip? Or the women's retreat that never even happened? Or the misdemeanor for disorderly conduct and shoplifting?
It said all you can eat crab legs. It didn't define where you had to eat them.
Pastor, we're getting there.
Blackout. Scene 4. Paradise Plantation. Pearl, Trixie, Ginger, and Barbara flip through a plastic surgery book with before and after pictures of patients.
Why, you can do that? Wow. I wouldn't have recognized her. Why would anybody let you take a before picture? You'd probably get a discount. And that explains why her kids are so ugly.
I never knew Mary Jane had all that work done. Poor thing, maybe now she can get a husband.
This one looks like she had her shoulders sewed back. Is that the procedure? Maybe it fixes osteoporosis. Her driver's license, they say 1943, but her behind says 1997.
What is that?
I didn't know you could do that there. All right. Hope you're all happy. I could lose my job for this. So, am I officially a sister or what?
Indeed you are. Why don't you come with us on our scouting trip to Mississippi?
Buddy the handyman enters with tools.
Well, hi there, Buddy. It's nice to see you.
Morning, ladies. Miss Ginger, I think that window's just about fine. Did I hear y'all talking about Mississippi?
Maybe.
Y'all planning on doing some gambling again? No. You remember what happened last time?
Mm-mm. No.
Well, you ladies have a fine day. And Miss Ginger, thank you for that strawberry shortcake. I hope I see you again real soon.
What? He fixed my window.
I bet that's not all he's working on.
Carl Louise Watkins, would you get your mind out of the gutter?
I gotta get home. Shark Tank's on. I know they're gonna call my name any day now.
How many times do I have to tell you? A vacuum cleaner without any cords has already been invented. It's called the Roomba.
And how many times do I have to tell you that's a dance? Don't you watch Dancing with the Stars? Better walk me home. It's dark out. Darn couch out again. Am I what?
Are you scared?
No. I want my HOAs back. Plus cataracts and a dark night make a bad combination.
I told you to get that surgery.
Yeah, well, don't get me started on the surgeries I've been telling you to have.
Blackout. Scene 5. Pathway, Trixie's place. Buddy enters looking up at the moon.
Strolling in the moonlight, out in the dark night, wishing you were here with me. I'm always strolling in the moonlight, thinking of you. one step away from being kicked off this boat.
Look here, Skippy, you need to respect your elders. Don't use that tone with me.
Barker climbs on a chair and keeps singing.
Yeah, far, where ever,
another $4,000 expense here for bereavement and Christmas in New York City?
Well, first of all, Pastor, we killed two birds with one stone because we needed ideas for a Christmas decoration. You know, Lincoln Center is just as lovely as can be that time of year.
Yeah, but I attend the funeral of one of our dear departed sisters.
She was a valuable member of our congregation, despite being a Yankee.
Who was it?
Selfie.
much. How did you know my brother?
We worked together, Pat Lover.
He was so many things to so many people.
Yeah, you just can't put him in a box.
Technically, they already did.
We are so sorry for your loss. All our loss. Of all of our losses, we are all losers. We spent $618 on pizza and hot wings. I'm personally shocked that some of our congregation found your sassy senior swimsuit calendar a tad offensive. And my personal favorite, when you advertised that Joel Osteen would be speaking at our Sunday services, I should have known something was up. Come over and curl my hair that morning.
But you got to admit, Pastor, the tithe was good that week.
Can we talk about the time you ladies called the entire deacon board in during their lunch hour for an emergency deliverance from demons?
Actually, Pastor, that was my husband, Glenn. And it wasn't demons. It was my dead mama. He thought she was haunting him.
Her mama never liked got worse when she went to the other side.
Trixie kept her mother's ashes down in the basement.
Actually, they're still there. I was supposed to spread them over the ocean with my so-called sisters, but that never happened.
And when Glenn would go down the basement, chairs would move, pictures would fall off the walls. The poor fellow was traumatized.
Have you ever seen The Exorcist, Pastor? What about The Shining?
Cease, you must.
Have you ever met my friend Jim Beam?
He pulls out a small bottle of alcohol and hands it to him.
You know, they give these out free on the airplane and casinos, but not the mini fridge at those fancy motels. That I found out the hard way. You are a disgrace, teetotaler.
Our next item up for discussion is youth ministry. I see you formed a subcommittee drawing quite a hefty budget. But what puzzles me is that I don't recall you ladies attending any of our youth activities whatsoever.
Well, see, now that's where you're confused, Pastor. That's why we formed a subcommittee. It's not their youth ministry, it's ours, or the preservation thereof.
Excuse me?
Someday you'll understand, young man, that women of a certain age need to take action against the epidemic known as ageism.
What she's trying to say, Pastor, is that no woman likes getting older, especially to the point where others are acknowledging it.
Can you only imagine what I went through
like the gambling.
No, I'm the name it and claim it kind. The more I know, why, the better I pray.
Blackout. Scene 14. Interior chapel flashback. Barbara, Trixie, and Ginger are reading the prayer requests while Pearl eats the leftover crackers.
You do realize you're eating Jesus' body, right?
Yeah. And I'll drink his blood, too, if I can find it.
Now.
been there if it wasn't for Miss Pearl needing an intervention.
We even tried to call that TV show Hoarders,
but we were so sure she was so bad they wouldn't even take her.
Plus, she had already been to prison. We didn't want to expose her on TV and have her hauled away from her third strike. We learned that on Judge Judy.
You need to take a lesson from Judge Judy, Pastor, because then you wouldn't be in the predicament you're in right now.
Me?
Blackout. Scene 16, interior of Pearl's garage. In complete disarray, looks like a crime scene or an episode of Hoarders.
through thick and thin. So how did you end up here?
Jesus. Baby Jesus.
Now don't you go blaming our Lord and Savior for your disrespect in not wanting to get him real points in you.
Excuse me for trying to be progressive. Hey, flowers aren't just either. Talk like some people I know. I don't remember the verse in the Bible where the Magi brought baby Jesus gold, frankincense, and points at him.
Yeah. Excuse me. But I do remember the verse about the glow sticks and the strobe lights.
It was brilliant.
Why do y'all have to act so ugly to one another? I am sick and tired of it. If you excuse me, I gotta go powder my nose.
So this is all about poinsettias from last Christmas? That's why none of you have spoken to each other or served this church in any way in over a year? Because of some plants?
Blackout. Scene 18. Interior church sanctuary. Flashback. Trixie decorates the Christmas tree as Barbara walks in carrying the baby Jesus.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. And bring me a grandson. He looked just like you. And bring me so much joy. Oh, he bring me so much joy.
Honestly, I'm at a loss for words.
That'd be a first.
You ladies need to think about where your hearts are and recognize what you have is a once-in-a-lifetime gift from God, a friendship. And you're about to throw it all away over something as stupid as poinsettias. And one more thing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres.
All exit except Pearl. Pearl stays behind to take a piece of cake. Then puts all the cake in her purse and leaves.
Snap.
Blackout. Scene 20, interior church sanctuary, flashback. Pearl enters with the trash bag.
always do. But where would I find toiletries to take care of 342 veterans at this late hour on Christmas Eve? Yeah, I'm sorry. Merry Christmas to you.
Pastor trips over the trash bag for a laugh. Hotel shampoos and toilet paper fall out.
Allow me. That was fast.
Blackout.
And I'm in charge.
appreciate all your energy and all your time. I think time is the most precious gift, and we appreciate you all coming out and sharing this evening with us. You all are part of the development, and believe me, Claire was writing laughs after every line to make sure that lines work. That's part of the development, so we appreciate it.
And we have Lucas here. If you guys would be so kind, we're collecting 30-second testimonials, something in the vein of, I loved it, it was better than Cats. You know, just whatever. Guys, we're going to have a big drawing, and when the show premieres someday, the best testimonial is going to get a free t-shirt. So you guys,
by the way, the video is only for our purposes,
yeah,
and for investor purposes. And we're not going to put it on YouTube. We're not going to put it on Facebook. Your mom won't recognize you in Wisconsin. No, that's my daughter.